Hi folks, this is David Kwan here. So, pretty exciting news recently. I've been reading about how the Obama administration plans to really kind of extend the overtime pay threshold. What this means, so I'm kind of learning this as I go too. I don't know too much about the details about this other than some articles I read here and there, some New York Times, some Huffington Post. But basically what I know is that like since 2004, in the time of the Bush administration, there is this threshold set. So if you're a salaried worker and you're earning below like $26,000 a year, if you're earning less than that, then you qualify for overtime pay. I could be wrong on the exact number. It could be 23,000, it could be 26,000 something, but that's about the amount, which is a very low salary. I can't even do the math, but that's less than $15 an hour, I think. So we're talking about like a very small population of workers or maybe a large population, because a lot of people make under less than $26,000 in America, unfortunately. But they're qualified for overtime pay, but somebody earning above that and they're salaried workers are not qualified for overtime pay. And this particular thing, I think, affects this news. I think I've seen a lot in like the blogs and press of social workers, like Social Work Helper and some other social worker website was kind of going around, you know, talking about this news that Obama administration is trying to push for a higher threshold. And that's for us in this profession is really great news, because we are salaried professionals who do tend to earn not that great a salary compared to other master level professionals, like, you know, people with MBAs, even people with MPAs. So it's a very, like, you know, it's a nonprofit sector, and we are, a lot of us are, some of us are bachelor's level professionals, a lot of us are master's level professionals, but we are salaried workers. And so the news that, you know, somebody with an income less than 50,000, that could be the threshold, would be qualified for overtime pay. I mean, this is pretty exciting news, especially for me in this profession. As a social worker, I do not make more than 50,000. So of course I would qualify for overtime pay. In my current job, it says, you know, I am not eligible for overtime pay, which is interesting. So, you know, on that note, I think it's a good news. I'm not dissing the news whatsoever. My personal take though is that it doesn't really necessarily, or it wouldn't usually apply to me, because I do not like the concept of having to do overtime to make ends meet. I want to just work my regular hours, and so that would be enough for me to make a living off of. I like that concept. I don't like this whole, like, you know, like, do I have to do overtime to be able to, you know, afford my rent, make my loan payments, yeah, have food on my table, you know. So that's kind of my thing. You know, I like to be able to do my hours at work, maybe stay a little extra if necessary to get some stuff done. I mean, I just tend to do that because I am kind of an alcoholic. But then, you know, I do stop myself from doing that, and I usually will clock out at the usual time, just so that, you know, it's not like I'm cheating the system or whatever. So for me personally, it shouldn't apply to me. You know, I don't want to do overtime, really. Like, I remember back when I was working at the shelter, the one thing I really hated doing was these things called double shifts. These are back-to-back 8-hour shifts, so it'd be a 16-hour shift. And that's because of coverage. You know, it has to be a 24/7 operation. I do an 8-hour shift. If the person coming after my shift has called out, and if nobody can cover for that, then I would have to do that extra 8-hour shift because no one else is there. It has to be 24/7 coverage, and I hated that so much. Just having to do a double shift. Yes, I got money and I got overtime pay a lot because I worked a lot of hours because of the double shifts. But it really was not an enjoyable way of earning money. And so I don't particularly think that, like, I would. You know, if this is passed, I wouldn't really be the one to take advantage of the fact that I am eligible for overtime pay. I still want to do my regular hours, and that'd be it. But I think it's great to acknowledge that there are salary workers, I feel like if you're making less than $50,000 a year, which isn't that great, but I mean it's for me it's good enough to make a living and be comfortable with, but it's still something that I think I agree over time should be accounted for. And that's not to say that I won't ever work more than 40 35 hours a week. I mean, I kind of already do anyway, and in many other instances I volunteer my time on these kind of projects and whatnot. And probably in the future I do plan to do my social work job and maybe even become a adjunct professor at a university or a college, and on top of that, or do other things, more freelance kind of work, consulting work that is kind of outside that purview. So, in the future I might work 60 hours a week, 70 hours a week. I'm not opposed to necessarily working more than 35 hours a week, but I think my point for me is that I don't really want this idea of, oh, now you're eligible for overtime pay. That still means we're gonna keep paying you like crap. But since now you're eligible, it just means that you're gonna, we're gonna o work you more so that you make your whatever, and we can keep your salary low this way. That's what kind of concerns me about being excited about this news. But don't get me wrong, it is good, exciting news that this is happening. Anyway, that's my two cents. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Cheers.